Welcome back to the fifth video in this series on professional PHP development. In this video, I want to share the why and how of service containers and how they make your application so much simpler. As you can see, I have a controller in front of me. And if we head to the browser, we can see the response of this controller. If you want to know how we ended up at this point, please make sure to watch the previous video. But for now, we'll start from here. For a container to make sense, we need to scaffold some more of our application, as right now, it doesn't represent a running state yet. So let's step away from this full controller and let's pretend we're an actual business selling product. So let's rename this to products controller. And then let's make sure that it's on the homepage. And then let's add a return type here because we didn't add that yet. Now in this controller, we want to do multiple things. First, we want to retrieve the applicable products based on some filter parameters. Then we want to return those products in HTML. But to keep things simple and not to repeat ourselves, we split this up into multiple classes. Let's start with the model class. So let's create a folder model within their product class. Let's create a folder repository in their product repository. And let's add a template folder within their layout.php file. And because we haven't touched any templating languages, let's just do it in plain PHP. You normally never do this, but let's stay with what we have right now. So we iterate over products as product. Bracket B. Oh, product. Product name. And then let's make sure that product actually has a name. And the last thing we need to do is actually add the method to retrieve all the products. So let's add a public function. Get all, returns an array. And let's mark it as products. And let's leave it at that. So we can finally go back to our controller and close all this. Now let's connect everything we have. So let's remove the piece of code we have here. Then construct a repository. We get the products from the repositories for repository get all. Then we have a template renderer, new template renderer. And we don't have that yet, but let's pretend we have it. And then we call a template renderer render of this layout.php with our products variable products. And let's clean up the method a bit. So we can move this get all call to here. Let's spread out the method call here. And you can see that there's two parts of this method. First, we set up our classes we need, and then we call a couple of methods on these classes. And right now, setting up these dependencies in this method is quite simple because the classes don't have any parameters we need to pass along to them. But let's assume this template renderer needs a folder in which the templates live. In this case, it's called template. And for our product repository, we need a way to interact with our database. And this is not the case right now because there's nothing in here. But let's assume it needs a database connection. So to composer require of doctrine eval and add it as a constructor argument here. So we need a connection of doctrine eval. Now to actually pass the connection, we need to call the driver manager get connection method with a bunch of parameters. And we need to pass the database name, the username, the password. And even though we haven't set it up yet, you can get where this is going. So this is getting quite complex for a controller. And instead of doing this, we can also require these as parameters for the invoke method. So let's do that. We have a product repository, and then we have a template renderer. But then we can remove these four lines. And let's reformat our arguments a bit here so they become legible and remove the import. Now called product repository. As you can see now, our method does one thing again, but we now have our dependencies one layer up. And we don't call this invoke method ourselves. It's called by our router package. And as of right now, we have it configured in routes where we instantiate the router, we map the routes, and then in our index file in the public folder, we let the router dispatch the request and emit the response. So if we want to configure a container for this router, in this specific package, we need to call the setStrategy method and call a new application strategy. Set the container on there. And right now we don't have a container package yet. And we actually have quite a few choices because this setContainer method expects a class that implements a container interface. And this is in a package from PSR called container. And most of the containers out there actually implement this interface. Now to keep things simple, I'll just use my package here. It doesn't really matter. But then we have chosen something. And then let's instantiate here. Now the way this container and actually most containers work is with service providers. So you can see that there's an add service provider method here. And whenever we request a service from the container, it loops through all service providers and returns the instantiated class basically. Now we were in the process of resolving the parameters for the products controller. And the first one of them is the product repository. And we can add a service provider for the product repository, but there's a neat feature about most containers. And sometimes you have to enable this, but it's called Autowiring. And basically what it means that if we know how to resolve all the parameters of the constructor, we can automatically resolve this class. So if we just add a service provider for this, our container also knows how to resolve the product repository. So let's create a service provider folder. And in there we add a connection service provider. And we need to implement the service provider interface. Each package has its own interface, but the one here. And then we basically tell the container that if the identifier equals connection, then this is the right service provider. And then we register on the resolved set, add a new definition. So we do a new concrete case for the identifier. And then we add a closure here. So we do a driver manager get connection on a bunch of parameters. So we have a user and we have a bunch of other parameters here, but we don't want to add hard-coded credentials in here. So let's leave this up for the next video with environment variables. And to actually register the service provider, we already added a method call here, but we need to do a connection service provider here. Let's import both namespaces. And then we instantiated our container, added the service provider, but then we also need to pass this container to the setContainer method. So let's get back to our products controller and see if we can get this up and running again. We'll skip this template renderer for now and remove the code for that because we didn't configure anything for that. And we'll just do a var dump of the product repository to see if we can get the correct argument here. We switch our browser. It's complaining about the invoke method not being configured. So we need to pass this through a constructor for now. And let's do a private read-only of the product repository. Extra space, and then instead of it expecting a parameter in the invoke, it's using the argument from the constructor. We now refresh the page. It actually complains about the driver missing for the connection. So in here, we need to configure a driver. And we don't have a database set up, but we can just instruct it to use PDO MySQL. And then you can see that it gets an object of the product repository. And right now, our creation of our container is done in the routes file, which isn't that bad, but it's the routes file is now doing one more than one thing. And we might want to reuse our container and have all the correct service providers loaded as well in another file. So let's move this to a central file and let's call it kernel for now. And let's add a public function getContainer. Returns a container. Mark is static because we want to make sure that there's only ever one instance of the container. So we add a property for that, which is also static. So if property is set, then we can return the existing container. And otherwise, we create a new container. And instead of manually calling the add service provider for each service provider, we want to iterate over all the configured service providers. So let's add a private function for this. Get service providers, turn an array. And we actually want an array of class strings of this service provider interface. So we return array, and then we do a connection service provider class string here. Also needs to be static for it to be able to use it in a static method. And then we call get service providers, iterate over that as a service provider. And then we want to register it on the container. So we do a new service provider. And then we need to actually return it from here. Okay. That looks quite good. We didn't use this method yet because in the routes file, we still have the old container construction. So let's clean this up a bit. And then here we do a kernel container. Import this. So we've spent quite a lot of time on implementing this container. But from now on, we can request any service in the constructor of a class as an argument, and it either already resolves automatically through autowiring, or we just need to add a service provider and register it in the kernel. And if we have a huge class hierarchy where the controller requests a service, that service requests a repository, that repository requests a connection, we don't need to manually pass all the parameters to all these classes. For now, I want to leave things here as we have done quite a lot in this video already. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll hopefully see you in the next video.